Hello and welcome to our channel Salesforce Space. In this video, we will discuss about how we can create a custom object in Salesforce. As discussed in our previous video, custom objects are the objects which are created by Salesforce admin user. Now, let's quickly log into our Salesforce org. After logging, we will navigate to setup page, click on the object manager and click on the create custom object. Create custom object from a spreadsheet. We will discuss in our next video. Now you can see there are several options which defines the object functionalities and properties. We will discuss one by one. Label. This will be the name of this custom object that will be displayed in UI. Plural label. This is just plural name of this object. When your object name starts with vowel, check this box, otherwise leave it as default. Object name is a unique name used to refer to the object. You can only use alphanumeric characters and underscores. The name must begin with a letter and have no spaces. It cannot end with an underscore nor have two consecutive underscores. Description. It is an optional description of the object. If especially for this object you want to display a custom help page that you have created using Visual Force page, you can select this option and you can choose that specific Visual Force page, otherwise leave it as default. Record name. When you create an object, along with the object a field will be created that will be the record name. It can be either text or auto number. In the text, user will give input, and in the case of auto number you have to define display format. I am selecting auto number for employee ID. Auto number is a read only field. And for the format, I am giving EMP0000, and for the starting number, I am giving 1. So these are the records. For example, auto number will be generated like this. In the display format, you can have up to 2 sets of curly braces. These are some optional features. Allow reports, makes available of this object records for reporting purpose. Allow activities, allows user to associate tasks and other activities on the record level. By allowing these chatter groups, user can add records to this object to the chatter groups. If you want to track changes on the field of this object records, you can enable this track field history. Enable licensing. This is the only read field which indicates whether this object is licensed by Salesforce and whether user requires a permission set license for it. Now, allow sharing, allow bulk API access, allow streaming API access. When these settings are enabled, the object will be an enterprise application object. When these settings are not enabled, the object will be a lightning application object. We cannot select one of these, we will have to select all along. Deployment status indicates whether the custom object is available for other users to create records or not. In development means object is not ready for create records for other users. Deployment means object is ready for the store the records. Allow search will allow our users to find this object's record when they will search from the global search or SOSL query. This option will allow users to attach notes and attachment to this object's record. If you want to create a custom tab for this object immediately after you create this object, you can select this. In other way, you can also create the custom object tab later from the setup. Now we can save this object. Great, you have just created a custom object in Salesforce. We will discuss about how to create custom object from a spreadsheet in our next video. Subscribe and hit the bell icon for next update. Thanks for watching.